and welcome to the Big Bang Show. Today we are going to be going through some of your favourite TV shows.
Let's kick things off with some carpool karaoke.
Let's get this show on the road.
Let's jam.
Thank you very much.
Sweet sugar candy man.
Oh, beautiful.
I'm a low down gangster, set tripping banker. And my homies are down, so gonna rock my anger.
Ooh. What is your ideal night out?
Jazz bar in Berlin.
With Mr. Dixon?
No, stopped.
I'm burning through, nothing to do. Far away, far away.
Is that good, girls? Is that good?
Yeah, that's good. Well done, Mr. Thomas.
Do another one. The three-legged race in Oxford.
Are you serious?
Yeah, where you sort of...
What about your crazy nights out and being abducted by police?
Actually maybe arrested in Moscow, possibly.
I want to praise this car to heaven. I just want to sing 10,000 Reasons.
Like never before, oh my soul, I'll worship his holy name. I will worship... I will worship your holy name. Yeah.
Bye. It's been emotional.
Oh, I just gone to say James loves you.
What have we got coming up next, James?
Oh, it's a mystery.
You're damn right, Sherlock.
I have a case. Can you help us?
And who's us?
The Hellington student body, please! It's DJ Dave! His DJ set's been stolen!
Not DJ Dave's DJ set?
Yes!
The game is on.
Gavin, can you help us? There's a serial killer on the loose. One of the upper fours, we suspect.
A serial killer?
No, a serial killer, Graham. Jesus, you're slower than lunch here at 1:05.
It's Greg.
Let's go, John. The game is... something.
On!
Yes, that!
So, did you find it?
No, but you have. You took the set, didn't you?
I did take the set! I took DJ Dave's! DJ said I'm so sorry, we needed it for the flash mob!
I always thought she was insane.
Thanks, Sherlock. DJ Dave is very happy.
Now, for some 50 Blades of Grey.
For Mind Main.
I just have a couple of questions. Mr. Gray will see you now.
What was he like?
He was polite. intense, smart, really intimidating. Do you have any interests outside of work?
What about you? I'd like to know more about you.
There's really not much to know about me.
I don't do romance. My tastes are very singular. You wouldn't understand.
Enlighten me then.
I'm incapable of leaving you alone.
Then don't.
I had a rough start in life. You should steer clear of me. Got me hoping you
save me right now. Oh, that was a bit steamy, Corden. I'm alright.
You're not wrong, James. You're not wrong.
I think it's time for a break.
People often ask me what the benefits of the IB is for students. Well, one thing, the first thing, is that it teaches them time management skills.
First, you have to do two IOs and topics in a cast reflection.
Wait. Hey, Christy, I did it in a night.
That was due last week, guys.
It's a life skill. They play hard and they work hard. Oh, darkness, my old friend. Also, IB students learn to manage their stress very well.
Yes, my name is Eagle Piggle.
They learn about theory of knowledge and all the thinking skills that go with it.
Have you done your top essay?
Yeah, I stuck to the strict guidelines that Mr. Wilson gave us.
Top was a complete waste of time.
Have you done it?
Yeah, last week.
Sugar Puffs!
And of course, we're one big happy IB family.
Hello everybody and welcome back to the Bait Bait Show.
Up next, we've got one of my favourites.
My two, Corden.
When I say David, David, you say Brian. Just play Planet Earth.
Travelling in huge numbers is itself very advantageous, but there's no organisation or hierarchy, there are no leaders. Any animal could start moving and thousands might follow.
When she has a target in her sights, nothing will break her concentration. The gossipy banter can sound to scientists like sentences with words or even names for each other. Weighing almost a ton, they use power and speed to try and push each other off their feet. This male is lucky to escape a fatal stabbing. But this stallion has claimed it as his own. He's been waiting months for visitors. Female visitors.
So, excuse me, how would you say you've hit your stamina?
Well, some say I'm the most out of the bedroom.
Okay.
It's his first chance to mate for a very long time.
How would you rate your stamina out of 10?
8.
What is your position of choice? On the rugby pitch.
Props. Lethal.
That was another great episode. Now we head over to Studio 2 where we'll be joining James for some celebrity interviews.
I get on well with some of the blokes.
One with Mr. Wilson.
Mr. Thomas. Mr. Thomas is very good.
Miss Rate.
Really?
Sacked.
Yes.
Very clever, very hardworking, very dedicated, and devoted to everything.
I just let them get on with it, really.
I think it's Mr. Wilson.
Tell them off. Tell them to calm down.
Just in control.
Mrs. Stevenson.
Mr. Fox. Miss Wilson. Mr. O'Driscoll as well. Yeah.
It's Mr. Cunningham, obviously. Dr. Morris.
Mr. Wilson.
I don't have any.
We're now heading over to the iHeartRadio Music Awards for their number one hit.
We are live. It's the 2017 iHeartRadio Music Awards.
Send it for Oxford.
Rich kids who pretend they're hard. Abington, you're about to get pard. Sending for you from Headington Hill. Don't be offended, try and stay chill. Oi, yeah, listen missus, we know you prefer little sisters. Pink and white, what an awful sight. Mate, I think you're like a sweet tie. You think we're jealous of Hellcats? You must be mad, you bunch of twats. That's enough about you chose. Let's talk about your posh friends down the road. Bradley, we know who you are. That trust fund ain't gonna go far. Spent it all on your failed shirts. Now you're gonna get verbally murked. You say Charles, I say Henry. See that bean on Round in Henley. Bless up Cunningham for setting us up. Baby trap a rich kid with any luck. Take your cloak off Harry Potter. We think Eton boys are hotter. See you at a job debate. Ever met a girl, you're desperate mate. And at last our sister school. The kids who think they're just too cool. So what, they've gone to Magdalen. We don't care, they're all neeks over there. Headington, Headington, that's where I wanna be. Getting it on with the lads at Cheney. Man sees me on Headington Hill. Popping that after pill. Yeah, that's right, I still get laid. Even with that A-star grade in Latin, science, maths and bed, your boyfriend screams. You wear suits, we wear Nike. Big hoops in, I'm such a. Oxford is your destination. Call it morning manifestation. You think you're Wavely, you think you're on fleek. Liar, you're just an actor, can't do drama. At Magdalen, boring. Get your work in, get your cos in. Get your grant in, get the grant in. You ain't even got no freeze. That's not including the Magdalen fees. God forbid you get any bees.
Can I have a day off, please?
Thought not, get on with your work. We'll be on the Astro getting turned. This is urgent, James. Cut Fox News.
And now for some news about football this week. Oh. Football this week is cancelled due to a parents' evening. Sorry about that. I'll send an email.
Next on the show, we have Orange the New Black. Bring on the boredom. I, for one, won't be bored.
The animals, the animals. Trap, trap, trap.
Lesbian request denied.
Right here. I would appreciate if you didn't harass me.
What's that?
What are you talking about? These are all natural.
Prisoners have 15 minutes.
Yeah.
Surely you like Sunday service.
Freedom. Freedom.
Okay, next up, let's see what the Headingtonians are doing in OX3.
Take me to Headington, please.
Yeah.
You may have heard the rumours that Headington's an exclusive world of snobs, rich kids and snakes, and the gossip is as startling as our school fees. Well, it's all true, and I would know. I'm Beatrice Norris, and this is my world. This season on Made in Headington. Truths are revealed.
John is such
a snaking is more fabulous than keeping friends. Oceans run high. This season, dramatic revelations about relationships.
I may be smaller in size, but I'm the assertive one.
Do you like when I dominate you?
We might be prudes, but we know how to have a good time.
Maybe I can't do it without alcohol.
Next up, we have Hell's Kitchen, The Hunger Games.
Another taster for you.
You've seen Gordon Ramsay in action.
Get that f***ing man!
You've seen Katniss Everdeen in action. Now, prepare yourselves to see the Borders in action. Boarding Trailers presents Hell's Kitchen, The Hunger Games. Borders will square off in an epic battle to choose from a variety of ingredients, exotic fruit, and prepare the ultimate meal like boiled eggs, fruit salads, pasta, more pasta? Starring Gordon Ramsay screaming,
"What the f***?"
Idiot sandwich.
What are you?
An idiot sandwich!
Cleaning the dishes. And lots and lots of shaky
shells. What are you doing in the kitchen? It's the middle of the night.
The true story of cooking in a boarding house, with special thanks to...
Ugh, they don't pay me enough for this.
Next up, let's see what the girls have been doing this week in the Jordan Shaw house.
YI.
This programme contains strong language, sexual scenes and references from the outset and throughout. I would never kiss anyone without 6 A stars. I should have a degree in pulling sickies in PE. The hardest graft I've ever done is getting that girl in the year above to give me her ID. Since going to chapel prayers that time, I've decided that I am absolutely immortal. Get me in this school because I'm going to tear this place up.
I don't know why I!
For the social tonight, we have decided that we have got to be better prepared for what's coming.
That may be bad, but I'm perfectly good.
I think we're ready. Why I? We're off to the social. We're proper buzzing and we're gonna smash it.
Hands up, put your hands up, put your hands up.
Now the party don't start till I walk in.
Don't stop, make it pop, DJ gonna make it up.
Maddie pulled an absolute worldie at the social. She's upstairs with him now. I had Gary's parsnip last night, and let me tell ya, it rocked my world. Why I, Gary? That law of 5 contraception class clearly did not make an impact, but something else did.
Thank you everybody for tuning in this week.
Join us next time on the
Beyblade Show.
Work it, make it, do it, makes us harder, better, faster.
So, what have we got coming up next, James? You just like, okay. So, what have we got coming up?
We used to live together.
We used to live together, yeah. Well, it's called a favourite memory, but it was certainly a memory.
Mr. Fox said that was his time where he,
weird!
Peace up, A-Town!
Oh, don't laugh!
That's nice.
About your sort of size then.
Mr. Fox is a bad man.
Anne's never been in Marquee
when it's shut down. That's the start, isn't it? Down.
When it's shut down, that's not me, it's shut down. Ring, 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 and it's shut down. When Fashion Week and it's shut down. Went to the show sitting in the front row in a black tracksuit and it's shut down.
Not me and it's shut down. Ring ring pussy, it's shut down. Hey. Fashion week and it's shut down. Went to the show sitting in the front row in a black tracksuit and it's shut down. Touch the road and it's shut down. Boy, you better know when it's shut down.
Yeah. Yeah.
Oh, I don't know the rest.
It's like Dominatrix. What's going on?
This is urgent, James.
Well, like bollockham, is that what you're sorry?
Yeah.
Is that language.
Just shout.
Oh,
Did I stop it working?
What Headington girls normally buy from here? Maybe I should ask that question.
That was really good fun. Yeah.
You got a friend in me. You got a friend in me. When the road looks ahead and you're miles and miles from your nice warm bed.
Are you actually going to take it?
You just remember what your past is. Or you got a friend in me. Yeah, you got a friend in me. You got a friend in me. You got a friend in me.